إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة أما بعد. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we thank Him, and we send salutations on the last and final messenger, Nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thereafter, I remind us before I start my khutbah of the situation still in the blessed land of Al-Quds. And we have to remind ourselves to always be in support of the Palestinian cause, of raising awareness. As we mentioned, Allah Azza wa Jal says, أَوَ كُلَّمَا عَاهَدُوا عَهْدًا نَبَذَهُ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ أَوْ أَلَّذِينَ عَاهَدْتُمْ ثُمَّ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدَهُمْ فِي كُلِّ مَرَّةٍ وَهُمْ لَيَتَّقُونَ. But today we're going to revive a sunnah from amongst the forgotten sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that is to recite Surah Al-Qaf on the minbar. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from his sunan Al-Mahjura, is that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would recite this surah to Arabs that would understand its meaning. So we will recite this surah bi-idhnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, starting Bismillahirrahmanirrahim Qaf Wal-Qur'an Al-Majid Qaf. Allah uses one of the huruf al-muqatta'a, and then He says, by the glorious honored Quran. The scholars say here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in over 30 suwar, He started the Quran with these letters, and immediately after these letters he praised or he mentioned the Quran. He swore by the Quran or made mention of the Quran. And the scholar, except in two surahs, in Surah Ankabut and Surah Rum, to show that some of the ulama came to a conclusion that Allah, He challenged humanity and all of mankind and the ins and jinn to produce a surah like it. To produce a surah like it. But impossible. And that's what Allah says in the next verse. بَلْ عَجِبُوا أَن جَاءَهُمْ مُنذِرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَقَالَ الْكَافِرُونَ هَذَا شَيْءٌ عَجِيبٌ. But rather they were astonished, amazed. And جاءهم منذر منهم, that they came from amongst them a warner, warning them about the punishment of Allah, His عذاب. If you commit shirk, this will be the outcome. If you fall into sins, this will be the outcome. فقال الكافرون, so those who were disobedient said, what? هذا شيء عجيب. This is something strange, something against the norm. And the strangest bit of it is that they, Allah mentioned on their tongues, أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا ذَلِكَ رَجُعٌ بَعِيدٌ. That once we die and become dust, are you trying to say that we're going to be returned back? That is a distant, faraway thing that you're saying. We can never comprehend that. It applies in our day and age. How many people say today religion doesn't have a stance or any position to play in our lives? Or what? You trying to say that when we all pass away and we're in our graves that we're going to be resurrected? That sounds like some fairy tales. Allah Azza wa Jal is speaking about the same people at that time are the same people at this time. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ عَلِمْنَا مَا تَنْقُصُ الْأَرْضُ مِنْهُمْ وَعِنْدَنَا كِتَابٌ حَفِيظٌ.
that indeed we know how much the earth diminishes of their creation. وَعِنْدَنَا كِتَابٌ حَفِيظٌ. And we have a preserved book. What is Allah Azza wa Jalla saying? Allah knows every single moment, every single thing that we do in this world, every single moment of our life that goes away, every second and the length of how long we would spend in our graves. And with Allah is a preserved book, a preserved book, i.e. the Lawh al-Mahfuz. Nothing is hidden from that book. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
بَلْ كَذَّبُوا بِالْحَقِّ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ فَهُمْ فِي أَمْرٍ مَرِيجٍ.
But rather they belied the truth. They said that that was something which we've never heard of. Backwards, ancient, no room for it in our time. So they are in a confused state. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
أَفَلَمْ يَنْظُرُوا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَوْقَهُمْ كَيْفَ بَنَيْنَاهَا وَزَيَّنَّاهَا وَمَا لَهَا مِنْ فُرُوجٍ.
Have they not seen or looked at the heavens? Because they're wondering, okay, how are we going to be brought back? How? Allah saying, have they not seen the heavens? فَوْقَهُمْ كَيْفَ بَنَيْنَاهَا. How we built it, وَزَيَّنَّاهَا, and beautified it with the stars, the galaxies, and all of the beauty that we see.
وَمَا لَهَا مِنْ فُرُوجٍ.
And there are no faults, no deficiencies in the creation of Allah. As we know in Surah Mulk, what does Allah say? Many of the times, He says that your basar, يَنْقَلِبْ إِلَيْكَ الْبَصَرُ خَاسِئًا وَهُوَ حَسِيرٌ. That your eyesight, if you were to try and look at the flaws and the errors in the creation of the heavens and the earth, you'll find that your eyesight will come back to you bedazzled, i.e. tired, can't find no flaws in the creation of Allah.
وَالْأَرْضَ مَدَدْنَاهَا وَأَلْقَيْنَا فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ وَأَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجٍ.
And the earth, مَدَدْنَاهَا, we vastened it, وَأَلْقَيْنَا فِيهَا, and we put in it, رَوَاسِي, firm mountains, and we caused to come out of it every beautiful kind of thing.
تَبْصِرَةً وَذِكْرَى لِكُلِّ عَبْدٍ مُنِيبٍ.
A remembrance, a reminder, a proof for every abd who is returning back to Allah, who is conscious of Allah, who thinks about His creation.
وَنَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً مُبَارَكًا فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ جَنَّاتٍ.
That Allah says, and we sent down from the sky a blessed water. And we're going to find out more about how this water is blessed, all the parable that Allah gives. And we cause to come out as a result of this blessed water, جَنَّاتٍ, gardens, وَحَبَّ الْحَصِيدِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thereafter, He says, translating this correctly, as some of the vocab is beyond me, and grains from the harvest.
وَالنَّخْلَ بَاسِقَاتٍ لَهَا طَلْعٌ نَضِيدٌ.
And lofty palm trees, having fruits arranged in layers. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
رِزْقًا لِلْعِبَادِ.
Provisions for all of the servants. Whatever Allah created in the heavens and the earth, Allah Azza wa Jal made it for our servitude, to be of service to us.
وَأَحْيَيْنَا بِهِ بَلْدَةً مَيْتًا كَذَلِكَ الْخُرُوجِ.
And listen to what Allah says. And Allah says, and likewise, that blessed rain, we cause to give life to the dead, barren, infertile land. The land that you see that there is nothing on it, no life. Everything has been eroded of life. But then Allah sends down a water, a blessed water that causes what? Life to come about. Vegetation, fruits, all of these things that Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned, gardens, the fruits that Allah mentions in the Quran of the rumman, you know, of the pomegranate, of all of the types of khair. And then Allah says at the end, كَذَلِكَ الْخُرُوجِ. Likewise, you would come out of your graves. Likewise, that land which is dead, which people see and look at as being useless, nothing is going to come out of this land. Allah is saying, likewise, I'm going to send a blessed substance, a water, that would bring out each and every single one of you from your graves. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, reminding the people, Allah Azza wa Jal, He uses this parable and He says, speaking to each and every single one of us, He says,
كَذَّبَتْ قَبْلَهُمْ قَوْمُ نُوحٍ وَأَصْحَابُ الرَّسِّ وَثَمُودَ.
That you think that you guys are on top of the world, that you're running the show, that you're the only disbelievers. Didn't the people of Nuh, the people of Arras and Thamud, didn't these people belie our ayat?
وَعَادٍ وَفِرْعَوْنُ وَإِخْوَانُ لُوطٍ.
And Ad, who we sent to Hud, and Fir'aun, the one who said, مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرِي. I know no God but for yourselves but me. وَإِخْوَانُ لُوطٍ, and the people of Lut. وَأَصْحَابُ الْأَيْكَةِ وَقَوْمُ تُبَّعُ. And the people of Al-Ayka that Allah mentions, that He sent Shu'aib to, and قَوْمُ تُبَّعُ, the people of Tubba in Yemen. Allah says, كُلٌ كَذَّبَ الرُّسُلُ. All of them belied the messenger, the prophet. فَحَقَّ وَعِيدُ.
So my promise of those who disbelieve, of those who belie and belittle my message, will come to them.
Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thereafter says,
أَفَعَيِينَا بِالْخَلْقِ الْأَوَّلِ.
Subhanallah. Then Allah says, is there any flaws in the first creation that we made of humanity? Do you see any flaws in the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal, of how He created the human beings? And then Allah says,
بَلْ هُمْ فِي لَبْسٍ مِّنْ خَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ.
But rather they are confused of a new creation that we are going to bring about. They see no flaws in Allah's creation, in the human being, in the same man and woman. But yet they doubt the next creation. When Allah created Adam alayhi salam from kun fayakun, from be and it is, from no substance, from nothing. And then this time, Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to create you when your bones and your DNA will still be in the grave.
وَهُوَ أَهْوَنُ عَلَيْهِ.
And Allah says that Allah is the one who creates, and He will repeat that creation, and it's easier for Him in honor and way that befits His majesty and honor. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in these next verses,
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ.
Indeed, we created the human being, and we know what his inner self whispers to him. Allah knows what your soul whispers to you, what no one else knows. And we are closer to him than his jugular vein.
إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ قَعِيدِ.
When those who are on the left and your right, the angels, the scribes, are there patiently recording Everything that you utter, everything that you say, everything that you do. As if to say, be aware, be cautious of every single action that you do.
مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ.
That nothing is uttered from their mouth except that it's recorded by a raqib, a watcher, atid. Some people try to give the mufassirin, some people try to give them these names. Everything will be brought on that day.
وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٌ.
And the fangs, the pain, the intoxicant of death would come to you. For sure, guaranteed. That is what you used to run away from, ignore.
وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْوَعِيدِ.
And on the day when the trumpet will be blown, that is the day which is promised by Allah. For the good doers, Jannah. For the bad doers and the disbelievers, An-Nar. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ.
And every soul on that day would come with a driver, someone that takes them to their fixed time, to their fixed place, to their fixed appointment with Allah on the Day of Judgment, where they would speak about their sins and their good deeds.
وَشَهِيدٌ.
And the witness, to show that Allah does not punish anyone except that there is a proof against that individual, except that there are shuhada that witness against the wrong or the good that he done in this world. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
لَقَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا.
That indeed, you are in a state of heedlessness as a result of this, as a result of the dunya, as a result that you never fathomed that death would come and catch up with you.
قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ.
Say, verily the death that you're trying to run away from, it would catch up to you.
ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ.
Then you'll be brought back to the one who knows the apparent and the unseen, and he would inform you of every single thing you've done in this world.
فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ.
Then Allah says, at that time of death, Allah Azza wa Jalla will remove the veil, the barrier between your eyes, to show you the angels, to show you the adab, to show you the things which you were heedless of.
فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ.
So your eyesight on this day is sharp to the point. Yes, you might not have seen it in the dunya, but when the sakaratul maut comes, when the fangs of death come, those last moments, Allah Azza wa Jalla remove the veil and you will see the malaika. Either good news, abshiru bil jannah, glad tidings of Jannah, or fear wa'idun bin nar, or a promise from the hellfire.
Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَ قَرِينُهُ هَذَا مَا لَدَيَّ عَتِيدٌ.
And his qareen from amongst the angels would say, this is what I prepared. Everything written down for so and so.
أَلْقِيَا فِي جَهَنَّمَ كُلَّ كَفَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ.
Throw into Jahannam every disbelieving individual. عَنِيد. Arrogant.
مَنَّاعٍ لِلْخَيْرِ مُعْتَدٍ مُرِيبٍ.
The one who would prevent good happening. The one who would prevent good happening. A doubtful individual. Someone who doubted the hereafter, doubted the Rusul, despite the fact that Allah mentioned them all in this surah to say, you doubt the Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, how about Isa alayhi salam? How about Musa? How about Nuh? How about Ad wa Thamud? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, الَّذِي جَعَلَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ, that those who made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala another Lord. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَلْقِيَاهُ فِي الْعَذَابِ الشَّدِيدِ, so throw him into the hellfire. قَالَ قَرِينُهُ رَبَّنَا مَا أَطْغَيْتُهُ وَلَكِنْ كَانَ فِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ. And his qareen would say, Oh Allah, I did not misguide him. The shaytan would say, I did not misguide him, but he was in clear error. I'll read the rest of the surah for the benefit of time, with no translation, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى. قال لا تختصموا لدي وقد قدمت إليكم بالوعيد يوم نقول لجهنم هل امتلأت فتقول هل من مزيد ما يبدل القول لدي وما أنا بظلام للعبيد يوم نقول لجهنم هل امتلأت فتقول هل من مزيد وأزلفت الجنة للمتقين غير بعيد هذا ما توعدون لكل أواب حفيظ من خشي الرحمن بالغيب وجاء بقلب منيب ادخلوها بسلام ذلك يوم الخلود لهم ما يشاءون فيها ولدينا مزيد وكم أهلكنا قبلهم من قرن هم أشد منهم بطشا فنقبوا في البلاد هل من محيص إن في ذلك لذكرى لمن كان له قلب أو ألقى السمع وهو شهيد ولقد خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما في ستة أيام وما مسنا من لغوب فاصبر على ما يقولون وسبح بحمد ربك قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب ومن الليل فسبحه وأدبار السجود واستمع يوم ينادي المنادي من مكان قريب إنا نحن نحيي ونميت وإلينا المصير يوم تشقق الأرض عنهم سراعا ذلك حشر علينا يسير نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما أنت عليهم بجبار فذكر بالقرآن So to summarize, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he then mentions how the believers will enter into paradise. It will be said to them, udkhuluha bisalam, enter you in peace. This is the day of eternity, the day where you would live and never die. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُ, in it for them is whatever they want, and we have for them extra. I prepared for my servants what no eye has seen, what no heart has fathomed, nor ear has heard. And how many of the nations before you have we destroyed? They were stronger than you in might and power, and they established things on the earth. But do you see anything of their remains? Do you see anything about them today? قل قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وجميع المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في القدس اللهم انصرهم في غزة اللهم كل المسلمين أينما كانوا اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقيموا الصلاة